Could we talk? Servus. We come from Slovakia. From, do you know where is it?
Is it around? Isn't it Russia? Yeah. Is it close? What? Give me something close. I'm not sure. I never heard.
Czech Republic.
Oh yes. I know Czech Republic is.
We are in the past Czechoslovakia.
Yes.
Now we are divorced. Yeah. Okay. What? Two countries. Yes. Hmm? Okay. First question. What was on the press? What does really or what does only joke?
I don't have nothing against the smaller bodybuilders. I think that they work very hard, but it's to me in my career, many times I've been overlooked, and I've looked at lineups, and I get overlooked many times by the smaller guys, and it's because of my height that I'm being judged unfairly. And I think that if you look at the lineups, everyone is the same height. I don't have anything against the smaller guys, but for a taller person, once you get past the height 6'1", 6 foot even, it's a lot harder to put on the size. I've been doing this since I was 12, and then most of the stuff, like the smaller guys, I have no problems with. I think that they're great bodybuilders at every height and size. Yeah. But my point of view is it's a lot harder because of my height, and I've been judged unfairly because of it, and I don't get the credit that I should be given. Mm-hmm. And as far as the thing with like Gustavo, my main problem was my first Olympia, I was backstage, and I was behind Gustavo, and he was a jerk. Mm-hmm. He was a very arrogant, typical bodybuilder jerk. And in this sport, to me, there's too many bodybuilders that are jerks. Bodybuilders, if you're going to be a bodybuilder, you should be nice to the fans and the other competitors, unless someone does something. But when you act like a jerk, I'm going to call you a jerk. I'm going to call you a block of cheese. I'm going to tell you that you're an ankle biter. I tease the shorter guys because I got teased a lot by the short guys also because I couldn't lift the same amount of weight. I can't do the same thing. But when I lift the weight, I'm pulling the weight from the ground very far. My arms are longer than theirs, so it's a lot harder. And I get tired of the fact that I'm overlooked because of my height. Yeah. And it makes me, I'm very upset about it, and I feel as though I've been overlooked. I don't have anything against any of the smaller guys. Some of the smaller guys, I value their opinion. I've been friends with many of them for many, many years. But it's just, I think that I've been overlooked, and I think that it's more beautiful when you're taller.
Yeah, it's a bit harder to get the mass on the high. Yeah.
'Cause the 20 pounds on a smaller guy, it looks like 20 pounds. On me, it looks like 5 pounds. I have to be over 300 pounds because of my height, and I don't get the credit that I think that I deserve. I've been doing this for a very long time, and I get overlooked a lot, even when I am in shape, and it's just not fair to me. So I came to the point this past year where I can't keep my mouth shut anymore. I have to say how I feel, and this is how I feel.
Tak len tak v krátkosti, akurát sme hovorili o tom, že aký bol problém na tej tlačovej konferencii, tak spomínal, že problém v podstate nebol žiadny, akurát, že povedal pravdu v tom, že na tú vysokú postavu sa toho nalepí viacej za podstatne dlhší čas, takže musia makať v podstate tvrdšie, aj keď proti takým nemá nič. A s Gustavom Badelom bol akurát ten problém, že v podstate, keď on bol na prvej Olympii, takže Gustavo Badel vystupoval dosť arogantne a proste neraz si zatvára ústa a povie to, čo si myslí. Okay, what about your form this year? Are you satisfied or?
I'm very happy with the way I look right now. I'm in very good shape. Everything is there, but in this sport,
density.
I'm 305 pounds. I've been the biggest competitor every show I've done for the past 2-3 years. It's just in this sport, it doesn't really matter how good you look sometimes. Because if no one's going to look at you, it doesn't matter. And that's how I feel, like I'm not getting looked at. I'm not getting paid. I'm not getting looked at the way I should be getting looked at. I'm not getting the attention that I should be getting because of the simple fact, because of my height, I think the judges do not know where to put me. They don't know where to stick me because I'm so big, and they stick me in a different area as everyone else, and it's becoming very
as the smallest guy.
Exactly. Yeah. Me, when it's my height, and then the little smaller guys, they do the exact same thing. They have the same problem I have.
They don't know.
And it's just to me, it's just not fair, and I'm very upset about it. So mm-hmm. I am very happy with the way I look right now because this is the best I think that I've looked. I mean, I've been harder, but I was smaller, so I'm just as hard when I put on a lot of size. I'm over 300 pounds. I'm 305 right now. So. Yeah. I'm very happy with the way I look. My preparation is good. It was good. This is going to be a good show for me as long as I get looked at. If they just give me the chance and stand me next to some of the guys, they'll see that I am a great bodybuilder.
pýtal som sa o jeho ambície, tak hovoril, že no nie na ambície, ale v podstate som sa pýtal na to, ako je spokojný s prípravou a ako sa bude cítiť na Olympii. Hovoril, že je to super šanca pre neho, že spokojný je veľmi s prípravou, ale že čo sa týka rozhodcov, nevie, akým trendom to pôjde, pretože a tak ako u takých veľmi malých, tak aj tých veľmi vysokých posudzujú takým zvláštnym trendom, pretože je veľmi veľký a že dívajú sa trošku na ňo iný, inak ako na tých priemerne vysokých. Dúfa, že je pripravený super, má cez 300 libier, takže je najťažším a najväčším pretekárom na Olympii. Which place would you be satisfied?
I would be satisfied anywhere in the top 7, top 10. That would make me very happy. Because my first Olympia, the year before last, I was 15. And it was me and two other people with me. And I think that I was overlooked. I mean, I didn't even get the pose at the night show, and I was in shape. I mean, my first Olympia, there was guys, pro guys, that are supposed to be good. They were backstage vomiting. They were very smooth, and they beat me. And I'm like, they're not even in shape. They have butts that look like strippers, and they're not in shape. So it's very disheartening. And I would be very happy anywhere top 7, top 10.
Že bol by spokojný v tej sedmičke, v desiatke prvej. Že v podstate trošku oštvalo, minulý rok bol 15. ani nie kvôli tvarom, ako kvôli takej neférovosti voči výške. What's your tip about Mr. Olympia, new Mr. Olympia?
Oh, Jay's a great bodybuilder. He's a great bodybuilder. He's a great athlete. He looks very good. He deserves his placing. He waited his turn. He's been there He busts his butt. The guy's a great athlete. He was a great athlete the first time I saw him when he was very young in California, and he was good then, he's good now, and he's hard to beat. And you have to bring a very great package in order to beat Jay, which I don't think no one has this year besides Ronnie.
And don't you think that the judges gave the last Olympia Ronnie?
I think that it could go either way with those two. I mean, I think that if Jay was going to beat Ronnie, he should have been above and beyond. I don't think it should have been close, but Ronnie was not as hard as I've seen him. And I think the change in the day from the prejudging being Friday and the finals being Saturday, that messed him up. And I think that I don't want to take away from Jay because he deserves to be Mr. Olympia. The guy's been waiting. He's been Mr. Second Place for 5-6 years. He deserves to be Mr. Olympia. And Ronnie has been there for a very long time, and I think he should move on and let someone else get the title.
Okay, so thank you, and I wish you good luck. Okay.
Thank you.